What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another video. My name is Alicia and I'm a New York State licensed cosmetologist, and today I'm going to teach you how to achieve this curly, beachy, wavy look using a flat iron. So without further ado, let's get started. So to start, as always, I brushed my hair through so that it is nice and smooth and not free. Also, since we are achieving this look using a tool that has heat, make sure, do not forget to put some sort of heat protectant in your hair in order to protect it from any possible heat damage. I do already have something in from when I had my hair styled earlier. And the other thing that I want to mention before getting into actually doing the look is that this is such a good way to get the same like crimped hair effect without buying a crimper. For those who don't know, a crimper is pretty much like a 3-barrel curling iron that they're all connected, and you press it through your hair in order to get that specific waved look. So we're essentially trying to achieve the same thing, but with a flat iron instead, because this is a tool that you likely already have versus having to go out and purchase another thing. So it's the perfect beachy summer vibes type of hairstyle. So once you have your heat protector in and your hair brushed out, get your flat iron, plugged in, heating up. I have mine going at the highest setting. This is a super old Qi. I have literally had this, I think, since I was in 8th grade, maybe even earlier. It has lasted me forever. I will admit I'm due for a new one, but I'm holding on as long as I can. I typically use this tool at the highest heat, but do whatever is best for your hair. Be mindful of the texture of your hair, if it's thicker or thinner, how hot or how not hot you might need it. And again, I want to emphasize one more time to use that heat protector. Okay, so hair is brushed out. I'm rocking a middle part today, and then I just pulled my hair to either side. And pretty much for this, I'm just going to be taking big sections because I want more of that like looser, beachy type of wave. And I'm going to also just separate out my hair going vertically from front to back. So to start off, I'm going to take about an inch or so of hair. This is going to include my front pieces. And actually, because of how wide this section is, I'm going to split it in half. And I'm going to just kind of push that to the side and start with this little bottom section. And so I'm going to take my curling iron and I'm just going to kind of rotate it one way and then rotate it the other way and press it down just for a few seconds and then repeat all the way down. If you have long hair, this might take you a minute, but enjoy the process while you're doing it. And just let it rock, you know? So that's that first section. I'm gonna take the rest of this top section down and I'm just gonna repeat. We're gonna hold the hair in one direction and press. You could also pull it through a little bit and then you can see that curl starting, and then just go in the other direction, press, pull through a little bit, press, pull through. That's one way to do it, or you can do it like the section that we were doing before. And I like to shake it out a little bit just so that it doesn't get too like stiff or anything, but you're starting to see that we're getting that like crimping effect as we go. And then honestly, you guys, this is it. This is what we're doing for the entire head. So again, I'm gonna take about an inch section, about this much hair. It looks like more than an inch because we're doing vertical sections. And then I'm going to separate out the top and the bottom. And then I'm gonna just repeat the process. And it's honestly a little tricky, so be patient with yourself. And like I said, just have fun with it. Hold it for a few seconds. And then in the other direction, hold it for a few seconds. Other direction. Don't worry if you see any smoke, that is my heat projector. That is just the product. And then slide that on through. And you see this bottom half isn't really giving me the full wave that I want. So I'm just gonna go in and try it again. That I like a little bit better. And then I'm gonna take the top section and repeat. Side by side. It doesn't look too different just because I did have a slight curl already in my hair. This is the side that is not done, and this is the side that is done. And it's just like loose and fun. And again, you're kind of getting that crimping effect without using a crimper. Another way that you can also get this same effect without using any heat is to put your hair into some French braids, or just any braid depending on how high up you want them, but at least a 3-strand braid, and then sleep with it. And then in the morning you'll have waves that look pretty much like this, and they'll probably be even more defined as well, because the braid you could wrap, you know, as tightly or as loosely as you'd like. So I am loving how it's turning out so far. Something cute, simple, a little time consuming considering that you have to do every piece. But one thing that I'm also doing as I'm going is just kind of experimenting a little bit, holding the piece down, maybe twisting it around the flat iron and then kind of pulling it through, and then just experimenting also with going in one direction and then in the other direction. So just honestly, my suggestion, I have this baseline, but I'm also figuring out what I think might work as well for me. So have fun with it and try and do the same thing just so you can figure out what works best for you and for your hair. So I'm gonna continue on this side, doing the same thing, separating about an inch. I'm going to do top half and bottom half. Gonna start with the bottom half in one direction. Hold it for a little bit. Go in that other direction. Wrap it around. Back in that other direction. And then just kind of finish off the end. I'm gonna redo that because it's a little too curved. There we go. And then repeat on the top section. People dream high in the quiet of the night. You know that I caught it. Bad, bad boy, shiny toy with a price, you know. And then same thing, just go around and finish on the rest of your head. And here is our finished look, our loose beachy waves made with a flat iron instead of a curling iron or a crimping tool. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you next time.